Aces can win, aces can lose. If you draw an eight, it can drive you to booze on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Gene. That's an interesting opening poem. Deuces can win, aces can lose. Well, aces don't lose too often, but if you draw an eight, you're right, it can drive you to booze. You notice Gene said that like he believed booze. It's like he lives with that. We thank Helen Savani from Lynchburg, Virginia for that opening poem. Now, let's get to the card. Janice and Bettina, if you will, start loading in the cards. And as you can see, we have a game in progress with these Card Sharks. Craig Holman, our champion. Hi, Craig. Good to see you. Our visitor from England.
That's true.
Do you think you're going to stay now that you're here for a while?
Well, if I keep on earning a bit of money, I'm sure I will stay.
You've earned a bid here, $4,100 to be exact.
Very good.
Okay.
Very good.
That'll help you stay.
A little bit.
Good to see you again, Craig. And our challenger, this is Enid Lee. Hi, Enid. Nice to see you again. We met you briefly, so won't you tell us a little more about yourself?
Yes, my name is Enid Lee. I'm from Huntington Beach, California, where I teach math at Huntington Beach High School. I'm married to a teacher, and he teaches at our Crosstown Rival School, where I help him out because he's a varsity basketball coach, and I'm his stat girl.
Well, what happens when his school plays your school?
My students get very upset with me, but I have to root for my husband's team. But I root for my high school when they play anybody else.
That's fair.
Yes, that's fair.
Good to have you both back.
You.
Of course, you've cut the cards, so we're ready to get back to the match. Each player has a deck of 52 playing cards, shuffled and cut before we go on the air. Craig, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. And Enid, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue cards. We play the best two out of three. Craig won game one, so Enid, you need this game to stay in the match. And Craig, as we left off with question three, it goes to you. Okay. We asked 100 bachelors across the country, have you ever said I love you to a woman only because she said it to you first? How many bachelors admitted that they had?
Well, I know the best place to say it, but I can't say it, so I'll say there's quite a few if they've been in the right clinches.
Well put, Craig, well put.
I'm going to say 40.
40 bachelors have said I love you only because she said it first, Enid.
Well, Craig should know being a bachelor, but he's getting a little embarrassed, so maybe it's just a little bit higher than 40.
Even higher than
that,
huh? Well, we'll find out if it is higher. Enid, you go to the board first. If not, it'll be Craig. And the actual number of hypocritical bachelors who have said I love you to a woman only because she said it first is 47.
Oh,
it's higher, Enid. Enid, we left off with an 8 as your base card. Anytime you win the question, you have the right to change it.
Yes, I would love to change it.
Here's the next card off the top of your deck.
Oh,
big ace.
Oh, that's beautiful. I'm going to say the next card's got to be lower.
Lower than an ace. And it ends very much with a 3.
I hope the next card is higher.
Risking that card and this one higher than a 3. No, another 3, and it's not higher. It's the same. A break for Craig. Craig, you didn't win the question. You must play the 9 and call the next card.
Okay, I'm going to say it's higher.
You're going against the odds. Got a feeling.
Yep.
Higher than a 9. We'll see if his feeling is right.
Oh.
No. Intuition is one thing, but the odds are often the best. Now we'll set up with the tie. This is the sudden death. And Craig needs 2 cards. Enid needs 3. And a question to you, Enid. We took a confidential poll of 100 married men who were gambling in Las Vegas. And we asked them, have you ever lied to your wife about how much money you lost gambling? How many men admitted that they had lied?
Can you hear my husband chuckling out in the audience? We've had this experience before, and I think they might not want to admit they lost as much as they did. So I'm going to say it's a pretty high number and go with about 70.
How much did he say he lost?
Oh, it's been many times.
Oh, many times.
Yes,
oh, well, we won't go
I've
into it.
I've given up, right?
Enid says 70 have lied about how much money they've lost gambling, Craig.
I think every man gambles in some way, and they always lie. I'm going to say it's higher.
Even higher than that. This will decide control of the board, and the actual number of men who admitted they lied to the wife about how much money they lost gambling is 40, not higher. Enid. Enid, you've got that all-important control. You need 3 cards. Craig needs 2. Do you want to play it or pass it?
I'm going to pass it to Craig.
All right, Craig, you've got a 9. You can't change it. If you can turn both these over, it gives you 2 in a row in the championship. One mistake, Enid wins, and we've got a tie match. Call this.
Okay, I'm going to go against myself this time and go lower.
This time with the odds, he says lower than a 9, and he's
right
for 5. Halfway there.
Higher.
If this is higher, Craig retains the championship for the win.
Oh, yes, he did it
for the win. Craig, congratulations. Enid, you put the pressure on him.
I tried.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Enid Lee. Thank you, Enid. Come on out here, Craig. Congratulations again.
Thanks very much.
Craig will play the money cards right after we take time out for this commercial message. Back with our champion, Craig Holman, and the Root Yawn. Craig, you ready?
I'm ready.
Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on up there, Craig. You know how to do it. $200 you won in the game, yours to keep. This is the one. You're going to clean this out. You feel it.
I feel it.
All right, here we go. With a brand new deck of cards, we'll start you on the bottom line with new money to play with. You're going to bet that money. $200 and these 3 cards. Move up to the second level. We add another $200 of betting money, and we give you 3 more cards. Your minimum bet's $50 until you get to the top card, the big bet, where you must bet at least half the money.
Okay.
Craig's feeling hot. Let's get to it. Here's $200. As in the game, you have a choice of 2 base cards on the bottom level. When you move up to the second level, you can change your base card, and you can change your base card before you make that big bet. We'll start you off with a 9. Do you want
to change it? I'll change it.
You have to play this one, and it is a 4.
That's better.
Better card.
Okay.
$200 and a 4, Greg.
I'll bet everything. It's higher.
Everything. $200 higher than a 4.
Oh, no.
3 out of 4 times you have failed on that bottom line, Craig, but you've always made a comeback. I know you're going to do it again.
The 2 will be good.
Up goes the 2. We give you the other $200 of betting money.
$200 higher.
Everything again.
Everything higher.
$200 higher than a 2.
Yes. Right.
With a 4. That's the way to get him. 2-4.
400 higher.
Again, everything. $400 higher than a 4.
Ooh.
Oh, no! My goodness, the 4s and 2. Oh, what a cut that was, Craig. Doggone it. Come on down here. You and those money cards, well,
I wish I did as good as I did in the games.
You're not doing bad because you have $4,200, and he's still here. Maybe he'll get another chance. We'll meet a new challenger after this. We're back with our champion. Craig, those cards sure felt funny for you.
They were lousy.
But you play this game so very well, it's very possible you'll get a chance to do it again.
Very possible.
You have good intuition, and we say that's very important. Okay, Craig, time to put it on the line again.
Okay.
We'll set up 2 brand new decks of cards and meet our next challenger on Card Sharks. Georgia Coy. Hi, Georgia. Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you, Jim.
Will you tell us about yourself?
My name is Georgia Coy. For the present time, in about 3 weeks, I'm going to get louder. Meaning that my name will change from Coy to Louder. I'm from San Luis Obispo, and I work in the hospital business.
Good.
And my favorite hobby is collecting frogs.
Collecting frogs?
Right.
To eat them or what?
No, I've kissed a few and I found a prince, and he's here with me today.
Oh, wonderful. I know a frog louder. I would have recognized him any place, Georgia, of course. Good to have you here. Relax. You're among friends. Have
Thank
a good
you.
Time. You'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Craig, the upper cards, the red cards. Craig, we asked 100 people. For $1 million tax-free, would you sell your soul to the devil? How many people were willing to sell their soul to the devil?
It depends how many believe in the devil, really, doesn't it? I don't know. I suppose a lot of greedy people. I'd say about 60.
60 would sell their soul to the devil for $1 million, Georgia.
There was a movie just about that. And I'm going to say, I'm going to go with the movie. I'm going to go lower.
Lower. A lot of agreement on that one. The actual number of people who for $1 million would sell their soul to the devil is 21. Very much lower, Georgia.
Okay.
Georgia, please. Your base card is a 6.
Woo!
Do you want to play that or change it?
I would rather change that, Jim.
Changing it to a 9.
Oh,
ooh, not a good
not a
change.
Whole lot better, but I feel like I should go lower.
Lower than a 9.
Yes,
with
good.
A 4.
Good. 4 is opening my my door. I'm going to get Craig. The next one is higher.
Higher than a four. Oh, no, it's a three. And you lose Craig. Both cards back to the base card, and Craig gets a free chance to play.
All right. Yeah. Oh,
good.
Lower.
Card.
Lower than an ace. And it's a four.
I'll go higher.
Risking both cards higher than a four.
Yes.
For the nine. Now we'll freeze. We move the freeze bar over. We'll fill in the spaces for Georgia. And the question to you, Georgia. We asked 100 United States congressmen in Washington, D.C., do you think marijuana should be legalized? How many congressmen said yes, they think marijuana should be legalized?
What an issue. I have heard so many polls on that. I'm going to go with about 67.
67. Higher or lower, Craig?
I have no idea. I'm just going to go lower because I know there's a law against it somewhere.
Lower. I'll be fascinated to see the answer. I mentioned earlier that we were very grateful that the congressman took part in our poll. It is fascinating to see what their thinking is on something like this. The actual number of congressmen who think marijuana should be legalized is 35. It's lower. Craig.
That's interesting to know.
Craig, do you want that nine?
No, I don't want the nine at all.
And we'll change the nine to a seven. About the same thing on the other side of the eight.
Okay. I'll go higher.
Higher than a seven.
Yes, with a jack.
Oh, no.
I'll go for it. Lower.
If this is lower, Craig has the first game of the match. And
ten.
Game number one to the champion. And we'll set up for game two, Dennis. Well, pressure's on now, Georgia. Georgia
sure
Coy
is.
Louder. That's going to be a funny change.
It sure is.
Georgia, you need this game as the same two decks of cards are dealt out right off the top. Craig, we asked 100 women. Do you think Jimmy Carter is sexy? How many women said yes, they think Jimmy Carter's sexy?
I can't see how anybody could think Jimmy Carter's sexy, really. I suppose there's a few kooks. I don't know, eight?
Eight. Eight women found Jimmy Carter sexy.
Tough. That's a tough question. I feel that way myself, but the women of America tend to go with their president. I'm going to say it's a little bit higher.
Think they're higher.
Yeah.
Well,
it's
you know,
my own self.
There's going with your president and going with your president. I mean, when you talk about sexy, you're real. Well, the actual number of women who think Jimmy Carter is sexy is 15.
Higher, Georgia. Let's get a good base card.
Let's see if we can start Georgia off with a seven.
Oh, I could change that one, please.
See if we can improve it.
An eight.
You're having trouble with those changes.
My, not a good card, but I'm going to hope for a lower one.
Lower than an eight, she says, and no, it's a jack.
Oh, wow, tough
not
break.
Lower, and again, tough Craig gets a chance to play free. A four.
Okay, I'll keep
good
that
card
and go higher.
Higher than a four.
Yes,
with a six.
I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a six.
Lower.
Yes.
Oh, it's an eight.
Oh, no!
Freezing right up the middle.
Position.
Craig needs two cards for the championship. Georgia, don't despair.
Position.
Don't despair. Smile. Try this. We asked 100 unmarried women. When you are out with an attractive man, what bothers you more, when he tries too hard or when he doesn't try at all? Now, how many women said they are more bothered when their date does not try at all?
Boy, being a single woman, I'm not going to commit myself, but I would say about 65 of the women.
65 are more bothered when the date doesn't try at all, Craig.
Well, I think really most women, you know, that they think they're interested if they do try something, so I'm going to have to say higher.
Even higher than that.
Yeah.
Okay.
The actual number of unmarried women who are more bothered when their date doesn't try at all is 48. It's not higher, Georgia.
Oh, please change my base card. I need
get rid of that
good
eight even before I get over here.
It,
now
right,
you made a good
all
change.
All right. Next card's going to be lower.
Lower than a king, and it is very low with a two.
Fine, here I go. Next one's higher.
Higher than a two. Yes.
Oh,
a two.
Okay, lower.
Lower than
I'm
a king.
I'm going for the win.
A three.
I'm going
to
win this one.
To tie up the match.
Higher.
It is. Wow. We're tied. 1-1. Each player with one game and $100. And let's set up for the tiebreaker. Got a good match going, so let's keep it going with the tiebreaker, and we'll set up with just three cards up there and three questions. Good match. Craig, question to you. We asked 100 millionaires across the country, do you take out the garbage? How many millionaires said, yes, they take out the garbage?
If they're millionaires, most likely they'll have servants or something to take out the garbage. I'll say very few. 25.
25 millionaires take out the garbage, Georgia.
This is tough. I'm going with the audience. I feel good with lower.
Lower than that, even.
Yes.
The actual number of millionaires who said they take out the garbage is 71. Not lower. Craig.
If he keeps up, he's going to be one.
Your base card, Craig, is a queen.
I'll keep that, and I'll go lower.
Lower than a queen.
Higher. Please.
For the championship, higher.
Oh, yeah.
He did it again. Keep playing those cards. Great, Georgia. Thank you.
Thank you.
I hope you had fun.
I really did.
Good luck in your forthcoming marriage.
Thank you.
Thank you, Georgia.
Bye.
Georgia Coy. Come on at it, Craig.
I'm going to try this time on that board.
This time you're going to do it.
I'm going to try, yeah.
I hope so. Right now, we'll take time out for this commercial message. Back with Craig Holman, $4,400, and this time we're ready.
We're ready. I hope so this
time.
Okay.
Let's get to the money cards. Come on, Craig. You felt hot the last time, but maybe this will do it. And once again, Janice, if you will, start dealing out the cards. You're going to have seven cards up there to play with, and boy.
I just hope that all aces and twos.
All aces and twos, in order. Now, in the right order. Last time you got four and two.
Yeah.
If you get two and four, that's not too bad at all. Seven cards, a lot of money, and Craig, we are all with you. Here's $200. See how your intuition is and see how the cards fall for you. On the bottom line, we will start with a 10.
I'll change that.
Next card off the top of the deck, you must play this one, a six. A little better card to start with. You've got a six and $200, Craig.
I'll go 100 higher.
$100 higher than a six. Yes,
right.
An eight. Tough card, but $300.
Okay. I'll go 100 higher again.
Still trying to get higher. He wants to bet 100 on it higher. Yeah, he's right. Ooh, another tough card. You're inching along there, Craig.
I'll go 100 higher.
Going against the odds.
Higher.
You still want that higher one. $100 higher than a nine. Oops. No, it's a seven. Look at those terrible cards. Six, seven, eight, nine. Let's see if we can improve it on this level. We're going to move that seven up, give you the other $200. You got $500 and that big break. Now you can change that seven.
I'll change it.
Changing it to a 10. Well, you're consistent. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, Craig.
Okay. I'll go 100 lower.
$100 lower than a 10. A nine. But you're still inching along up to $600. That's not bad, Craig.
I'm going to go 100 lower.
$100 lower than a nine. A seven. I have never seen such bad cards make money for people. You've got $700 and a seven, Craig.
I'll go 100 higher.
$100 higher than a seven.
Ooh. Oh, no. That's a good card.
That's not right. Bad. Finally, though, that's a good trade for $100 because we're going to move that great card up here. I'm sure you want to play.
A lot. Higher.
The whole thing. $600 higher than a two. Let's pull this thing out. Higher. Oh,
yeah.
Oh, just barely two.
I landed on the two
for $1,200, though. My goodness. Craig, come on down here. You played those terrible cards well.
Thanks. I need some luck, man.
To get $1,200 out of that is not bad.
Thank you.
We'll meet a new challenger right after this commercial message. Okay, let's get set up for a new match and meet our next challenger on Card Sharks. Hello, Linda Sappington.
Hi.
Nice to see you. Where are you from?
I'm Linda Sappington. I'm from Fullerton.
We're delighted to have you with us.
Thank
we want to give you a quick chance to play the game,
okay,
so let's get right into it. You'll play the lower cards, Linda, while Craig plays the upper cards. And Craig, we asked 100 senior citizens in Miami, Florida, what does Starsky and Hutch do for a living? How many senior citizens knew that Starsky and Hutch are policemen?
I think a lot of senior citizens watch TV, and you know, that's about all they do nowadays. And I'd say, I don't know, 60.
60 knew who Starsky and Hutch were, Linda?
I don't know. I think they watch TV, but most of them watch Lawrence Welk, I think.
Oh, so.
I think it's going to be a little bit higher.
You say even higher?
Yeah.
You say more know who they are,
yes,
right? Okay, the actual number of senior citizens who knew that Starsky and Hutch are policemen is 37. It's not higher, Craig. Craig, your base card is a queen.
A queen, good card. Lower.
Lower than a queen.
All right,
seven.
Go on, I'll go. Higher.
Higher than a 7. Boom. No, it's a 5, and you lose them both. A break for Linda to play a 5.
Okay, the next card's gotta be higher.
Higher than a 5. It is a 7.
I'm gonna go on. It's gotta be higher.
Higher than a 7. Yes, with an ace.
Lower
than an ace. It is a 3. For the first game
higher.
Of the match, higher than a 3. Yes, and the challenger leads 1-0. Aren't you glad we started, Linda? We'll see you next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye for now.
A representative of the studio audience will receive a beautifully made Irish bed cover with pillow shams and pillows, a shawl-type throw for your bed at night, and a fashionable cover by day, the bed shawl furnished by Vittorio Originals. And some of our contestants will receive a Blue Luster shampoo or a new Blue Luster Plus carpet shampoo with grease cutters and brightness to remove ground in dirt and grime. And the Firebird fireplace heating system draws in cold air, forces out hot air. The Firebird makes most fireplaces more effective, so you can turn your thermostat down. And a $50 gift certificate from Sears Baby Shop, where you can select most everything for a baby, from quality sleepers, blankets, furniture, and more, even Winnie the Pooh. And Mohawk Carpet, 100 years of carpet craftsmanship, the Mohawk Luster Gallery Collection of shimmering, soft, sensuous carpets, now at your color dealer. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.